hunting was not always devastating for the populations of Pacific gray whales. For centuries, indigenous cultures hunted them for food, skins, oil, and bones. Early historical whaling records indicate that subsistence whaling occurred in Asia as early as the 16th century. But as the demand for whale products increased in the late 1800s, so too did mechanized commercial hunting. In the Western Pacific, net whalers targeted the whale populations off the coast of Korea, while in the United States, the California Gold Rush escalated the demand for whale oil to light the territory's mines. The death toll was greatest between the years of 1846 and 1890.
And during that period of time, there were, you know, up to 600, 700 whales being taken a year. So it was a pretty significant depletion of the eastern North Pacific population.
And then they stumbled onto the lagoons. And once they moved into the lagoons, that's when the carnage really took place, because they were focusing on not only the adult animals, but primarily adult females. And it caused the population to reach a point where it was no longer economically feasible to harvest them.
Eventually, in 1946, whale hunting in the eastern Pacific stopped with the establishment of the International Whaling Commission.
From 1946 forward until 2012, the population grew quite rapidly. In the past 10 years or so, it's pretty much leveled off at about 20,000 individuals.
The eastern North Pacific gray whale is a conservation success story. It is the only marine mammal that we've removed from the endangered species list. And I think the significant part of whaling, commercial whaling in the western North Pacific population, is that the whaling continued much longer, for another 20 years.
With whaling in the western Pacific continuing throughout the 1960s, the remaining numbers are very different.
Western North Pacific population, it was hunted down to near extinction. Some researchers thought it was extinct. It's listed by the IUCN as critically endangered. It's depleted under the MMPA. And it's endangered in the ESA.
Given the plight of the gray whale population, the team of NOAA scientists extended their research work in 1997 to the frigid waters of Sakhalin Island in Russia.
Our project was really the first to provide any current data on the status of the Western North Pacific population. There's very few animals in the population. Our estimate is about 150 individuals. And one of the more satisfying results is we've watched now gray whale mothers give birth to their calves. We've watched those calves grow up and give birth to their own calves. So we're seeing multiple generations now of animals that we've known for their entire life. In 2009, we handed the entire project over to Russian scientists. So it's all Russian now. It carries on to this very day, but it's all Russian scientists in the field. We support them now from here.